Hey, welcome back to Power Wash Simulator. We're doing a Scorpion Sentinel, and everybody's still here.
Pause, Spike.
You can read that later, losers.
You can pause the video and read it if you want to read the damn thing. I'm not doing it.
You can read about the choice labor laws, paying $150 to clean this thing.
For real, though.
Raise the arms?
Oh. Can you make it shoot stuff?
You know, speaking of labor laws, Have y'all seen that Arkansas is trying to get rid of the 16-year-old law? That way,
it
can be even younger.
It shouldn't surprise anybody.
That's just like the Scorpion Sentinel.
Like, I already hate it when a 16-year-old serves me something, because they usually get it wrong. Now there's going to be like a 15 or a 14-year-old messing up my orders.
They're not the first ones. Minnesota's already got 14-year-olds working.
Oh, my God. Remind me to never go to Minnesota.
I shouldn't have to remind you not to go to Minnesota.
I went to Minnesota once. It was wildly racist against Native American people.
Yeah, so's North Dakota.
Yeah, there's just a lot of signs with, like, happy waving Indian chiefs and... it's just weird.
But what if it was an Indian chief who put that sign there? You gonna think of that, Will?
Maybe they were
really happy about doing it.
Possibly. Something tells me not so much, though. Don't
you know?
You know,
it's never something that's ever come up in any of my videos, but the race of the people in my videos is usually pretty consistent, and now it's not.
This is our diversity video.
Yeah.
That's right. I was brought in as the diversity hire.
Yeah.
You and Bill.
That's our race, but it's not what you think.
Oh,
Plague and Garrick are Plague and Garrick are not white guys.
I don't know, I love being able to say just that sentence.
But it's a blue guy.
They are the diverse people.
Yeah. They're not getting paid, so I can't call them hires.
Nah, diversity volunteers. I'll take that.
Are you taking this thing, Lou?
What?
What the?
It's just really happy to see you. That's right.
Dude, how much power does this thing have? Like, is it just able to move infinitely? Does Shinra have the ultimate infinite power source?
Actually.
Brought it back around to Final Fantasy VII.
Thank
Congratulations,
you.
Sean.
Power. Made him the wild card. actually,
it was
though,
the so-called greatest military achievement.
It was,
as that guy in the text earlier said. Mm-hmm. That's right. I read something.
Not only that, but it's literally the first boss of the game.
This was the one that killed me.
Yep. So if you played any of this,
5 minutes into the game, boss time.
You met this guy.
All right, I'm gonna let everybody know right now. My experience with this game is going into this game, facing this guy within 10 minutes, dying, and shutting off this game. I have not played a single second past that.
That's valid.
And I was like, you know what? Maybe I'll play Super Mario Sunshine instead.
Maybe this is more
great for me, because Scorpion Sentinel just does not qualify as a boss.
He really doesn't. It's just a speed bump. Like, it's an opportunity to see what everybody's limit breaks do, you know? Like, that's it.
There are so many words there I didn't know.
I suck at Final Fantasy. That's all I'm going to say.
Ooh, we get to explain a limit break.
I played Final Fantasy 12 for, like, 10 hours, and I was over-leveled, so everything kind of just became boring, and I quit.
I played 7, 8, 9, and 10. I only beat 7, but I got to the end of all the other ones and just, like, avoided beating the final boss because I wanted to goof around in the world and just, like, do stuff and side quests. Like, Final Fantasy X, as soon as I found out there was, like, a monster hunting kind of Pokemon-esque aspect to it, game over. I just fucked the main story. Like, took a left turn and never looked back.
See,
are we allowed to say that on YouTube? I don't know.
Yeah.
Can we drop the F one?
Oh, can we?
I do not care. I've said cunt on this channel, and I'll keep doing it.
I'm bleeping that later.
I'm not sending you this footage.
download it directly from YouTube.
I'm just gonna I just hit record. I'm gonna go ahead and edit this footage.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you right now, if one of you downloads this video from YouTube, edits it, and puts it back up on your channel, I'm not gonna stop you. It will just be dumb.
I'll copyright strike it.
You copyright strike my video?
Yes.
Fuck you.
I'm gonna compose some music, give it to you for free, and when you use it, I'm gonna sue you.
That is something that happens on YouTube.
Oh.
Yeah.
Damn, I'm not original.
I've almost I've had to deal with a few people commenting stuff like that before, where they essentially say like, "Hey, we make music." Like, yeah, so do I. I quit putting it on videos because it was a lot of effort to write something original. A lot of it didn't sound good enough to be over gameplay, and so we decided it was a better idea to just not do that anymore. But people have commented before like, hey, we can give you free music for your gameplay, and I just have to comment nice things back. But they are definitely trying to pull the scam of, we'll give you music, but it actually doesn't belong to us. It belongs to a parent company that we're not even going to say exists. And then they're going to sue you for putting it in your videos, and you'll have to give them everything from the video.
What are those rivets attached to? Like, hold on. Like, down on the back of the claw? Sorry.
On the back of the claw? Oh.
Yeah, like, go back inside of it? No, inside of it.
So, whenever you're down?
Down into the claw, not the tail. That's a squeaky clean butt.
I think you're talking about the feet.
It's got a butthole. It has a butthole.
It has a hole. Right,
you said claw, so I was thinking the claw up there.
Yeah, he's talking about the feet, the inside show.
He does.
You're talking about the claw.
He knows exactly what you're talking about.
No. Sean is correct. It is the foot. It is the foot.
The foot.
So good at everything. My name's Blake.
Fuck. This is called a leg gripper.
Oh.
You can see it in the top left of the screen.
Wow. Good job, Will. You don't know anything about Final Fantasy.
Damn it, Sean.
Sean.
Man. Steve's going to have a time editing this shit.
Yes.
Clearly.
I guess it's two pieces welded together or something. I was just wondering, like, what the hell those little rivets are even doing.
That's probably armor plating, right?
Yeah. Or there's, like, an electronics panel or something in there.
Yeah, that makes sense, too.
I mean, there's absolutely an electronics panel in there. Pressure sensors and accelerometers. And,
Sure.
Accelerating this thing, doing.
What were they putting in the armor? Giant scorpion robots, I guess.
So why does everything look like it runs on diesel? On materia, you know? Because, like, anytime I see, like, a boss that's a machine, I always see smoke coming out of it. I always see it kind of, like, cranking up and down, like...
That is what's called a cyberpunk aesthetic.
Well, it also goes back to the, like we were saying earlier, just, like, it's kind of a direct, like, petroleum industry. Like... What's it? It's pretty much
no, I think this is directly an allegory for America.
Yeah, it kind of is. Like, it's not subtle. It's really not.
America's so great.
But naturally, pretty much everything runs on planet soul energy.
Yeah, no, literally. Like, it's not to, like, undersell that at all. They're literally, like, they drilled one day and just found, like, a giant glowing pool of cool of nice energy or whatever, and they were like, let's burn it.
Let's see what happens when we light it on fire.
The live stream, just so that our
fans
cannot be angry that we keep avoiding Final Fantasy terms.
Thank you.
So, the question is, could Bahamut beat this thing?
Yes.
You beat it at the beginning of the game, except Sean.
Like, various
probably beat this thing, so I don't hope so. Like, I'm still so confused how you walked in 5 minutes into the game and failed to beat this.
Because I'm really good. Don't call me out. My name's Plague.
Damn it. he was probably overwhelmed by its Mark 19 launchers, or Mark 99 launchers, which if you attack the Sentinel from the front for too long, it'll use its death grip and attempt to bind you.
Still have what?
Sure do.
Yeah, I'm figuring this is the wiki pulled up.
That's paragraph 4 of the wiki. Yeah.
Does it say how good people that play games good still die to easy boss?
No, that's it's not in there because that's not how it works.
Well, I'm champ 3 in Rocket League, so I don't care about this game.
Like, I literally think like 11-year-old me beating this boss on accident.
Shut up! You were probably really lucky. Like, really lucky. Like,
no, I just wanted to hit it with nothing but Barrett's Big Shot, so I just kept letting it hit me and then using potions.
What did I do wrong?
I don't know.
I need to go back to this boss.
Actually,
I just feel bad about myself.
I don't know what you could have possibly done. I feel bad for you too, so you know.
You know what? You know how sometimes when you play Yu-Gi-Oh! And the other opponent just has Exodia already? I think that's basically what happened.
That's what we call a Michael.
For those of you who don't know...
That's rolling a 1 3 times in a row.
Yeah.
That's what that is.
That's really unlucky luck. Plus 20 times 20 times 20.
Never in my life seen someone with that bad of luck with dice.
If it makes you feel better, you can play the remake. That way, Barrett will just fight it himself and beat it for you.
Isn't it timed when you fight this thing in the remake?
Is it in the,
not
in
this
the remake?
One.
Okay. No. In the original game, it is.
Maybe that's why I lost.
Wait.
Scorpion Sentinel? No.
No,
it's
not.
Air Buster.
Yeah.
Oh.
Which will come later.
Give me more excuses.
No.
I need to go back now and
literally
kill this guy dead.
You're gonna upload that on your channel. It's just gonna be one fight from Final Fantasy VII emulated on a PS2 emulator.
PS1.
One.
Yep.
PS1. That is a lot easier to do. PS2, you gotta get the BIOS. PS1, you don't have to.
It's just PSX, I think, for.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can talk about that on YouTube either, so.
I'd talk about all of it.
I gave
what is YouTube
slow...
gonna do? Cancel us? You can't cancel me. I'm too big. I'm
Look,
Plague.
They can't demonetize a channel that doesn't make money.
Ooh.
Or
I don't
they
make
can't
money.
Monetize a channel that doesn't make
Perhaps
money.
They will monetize you and then
That's
take it away.
Hey, I already said if you guys, if they ever monetize this, I was trying to say it earlier. I don't know if I did. If they ever monetize my channel, I will put monetization on this video and I'll give y'all a cut of it. But we've already said cunt and fuck and a bunch of shit about emulators. I don't know if it's going to get monetized, guys.
They changed the YouTube rules again. You can start cursing now as long as it's
I already
not
fucking did that.
Excessive, you know? I heard a British dude say fuck.
I mean, I gave a nice low and slow fuck earlier, so.
Yeah.
You're probably
fucked. Are you bragging? Oh, I'm sorry, I don't have anything.
Yeah, like, well done.
You're such a good lover, Garrett.
So thorough.
Why do you have to turn your fucking head? I'm trying to clean you off, you bastard.
Ooh, it's got a little like sticker on it. Look at that.
I wonder what it said.
Shinra. Is that a spoiler that this is owned by the Shinra company and you have to fight it? So that means that Shinra's the bad guys?
Well,
not bad people.
Well, to Shinra, you the player Shinra are the bad guys. So, like
Shinron, the dragon from Dragon Ball Z.
Just to be clear, we are definitely terrorists.
Oh, 100%. Like you play the role of a terrorist for quite a while. like in no uncertain terms. You are an eco-terrorist. You do many eco-terrorisms. Like, goddamn.
Nobody believed me when I said that Shinra was the good guy. Until right now. Now everybody knows.
Everyone's on Shinra's side now.
Plague, I'm the good guy.
Damn it.
Does that mean I can pick the name Shawnee D?
I mean, just given a lot of opportunities to copy and paste a name.
It is I, Plague.
Yeah.
Well, what if I, Shawnee D, told you?
I will say, Shawnee D, you have some great content on your channel.
It's not self-promotion if you're lying about it.
No such thing as bad publicity.
Yeah, what was your last video, Shawnee D?
Rocket League.
I mean, it was a good guess, wasn't it? It was a good guess, wasn't it?
That's a pretty good guess. No,
is either that
it's
or Tarkov.
Call of Duty. It's Call of Duty. Duty. Yep.
Call of Dudes.
That's weird because the video's called "Yeah, That's My Mom."
What?
That's all the context you need.
That's all you get.
I play.
It's a Wreck-It Ralph reference. That's my guess, so I'm sticking to it.
Did you know that it can also start using Stinger Salvo, which sends out 10 cannonballs?
I didn't know that.
Each of them do a small amount of damage. Yeah, just a small amount of damage.
Is that what those things are that are coming off their nipples?
No, those are wheels that it uses.
That's the buttocks.
Yeah, no, they pop out a little more and picks up its feet and scoots around on those.
Oh, really likes three-wheel designs.
I don't either. I don't like them. I mean,
it's really popular over for vehicles manufactured in Japan to have a three-wheel design because the front wheel, as long as you make it heavy enough on the front that that the center of gravity is sitting above the wheel rather than on the side, and you make most of the center of gravity towards the back, you don't have to worry about it rolling like a Reliant Robin. Did I just lose anybody there, or did you guys actually understand what the fuck I just said? I'm not a car guy, so when I say car guy things, people always kind of drown away.
I am a car guy, and all that, so...
I definitely heard all the things you said.
Yeah, I agree with Sean.
I'm sure you do.
My videos are never coherent, so your confusion is not really going to be a problem.
Nobody will know by the end. Nobody. Not even me.
Yeah, probably.
And this is how I'm going to help my social skills.
Calling people the wrong name and gaslighting them into thinking they own your fucking channel?
Give me your password.
Yes, it's all coming together.
This is one of them, their social engineering tricks.
Wait, why is his butt dirty again? You just cleaned the crap out of his butt a second ago, and it was shiny and squeaky, but like...
Well, that's a different thing.
Where's
all the stuff on the inside?
Yeah,
that I didn't clean out.
Ah, got it.
You gotta really get in cracks.
I never sit here and clean one thing and then the next thing. I just kind of move across the entire level. It ends up being fucking... I'm schizo when I do this shit, man.
Like hunt down the last.
I forgot that there was a whole field generator in its butt.
Yeah,
and it comes into play in the remake, where you actually have to get up in his.
Get up that.
You gotta get him in the butt. Get him in the butt.
The easiest place to enter a scorpion is through his hiney.
I mean, I would agree. Scorpions usually strike forward.
I forget in the remake, like it's a full. Like freeform movement battle system, like it's not turn based like the OG one.
You actually have the option to change it to a turn base if you want to.
Oh, that's kind of cool, actually.
It's free movement and everything.
Definitely.
It's the most active of time battles.
Ah, yeah.
This actually brings up an excellent point that we probably don't have. Well, let me check. We might have plenty of time to go over this. Does anybody know anything about the recent controversy around the term JRPG?
Oh, no. What?
Don't.
I believe multiple developers, there was one in particular, but multiple developers have now weighed in on it. A Japanese game developer basically said he remembered it being a derogatory term and thinks that it's time that we retire it entirely because it's not very descriptive and it doesn't do a very good job. And I found it interesting that he pointed out that it was derogatory, because I'd never thought of it in those terms before. But I do have some issues with the term. I was wondering if any of y'all have anything to say about the derogatory nature of the comment, or the idea that we should retire the term altogether.
I never thought of it as a derogatory one either. Like, I always thought it was just kind of a handy term to have, because, like, they are legitimately very different than what I assume would be more Western RPGs. But, like, honestly, at this, like, right off the top of my head, I can't think of a Western RPG game that was around at the time of Final Fantasy VII or had the same level of, I don't know.
So,
I don't know, like, it seems handy, I guess, because they are really different, but also, like, good? I don't know, just, I never really thought about them in a derogatory term.
So, coming from the non-specified, non-white person, of which there are two here, as mentioned earlier, it's not something you generally think about. There are tons of terms that people use all the time and think they're just normal terms that turn out they're very derogatory.
Yeah.
Word. Yeah, absolutely.
And there's people of those races that actually may or may not think of them as derogatory themselves.
Yeah, this is where a big fight for stand-up comedy comes in, where people use terms referring to themselves and others, and didn't know that what they were doing was referring to themselves and others by something that was really fucked up to say. And then they just kind of double down and defend themselves when they legitimately just didn't know, and they could have apologized and said, oh shit, I didn't know that, and it would all go away, but they don't want to do that.
So now that you're saying that, I mean, it makes sense as to why, like, maybe a Japanese person wouldn't want to just be like, oh, this is a Japanese RPG, because then that kind of pigeonholes them, you know? So if you do another type of RPG, or that it would be different from what people would consider Japanese RPG, but you're still in Japan and you're still making an RPG, would it be weird to call it a Japanese RPG?
I mean, if you are a Japanese developer and your game is an RPG, then it will be called a JRPG, and a good example of that is Final Fantasy, because Final Fantasy VII fits the JRPG term. So does Final Fantasy VIII, and so does Final Fantasy IX. Final Fantasy X does not fit it very well. Final Fantasy XII doesn't fit it basically at all, and every Final Fantasy game since then hasn't really fit it either. One key thing about what we generally refer to as JRPGs is that they are turn-based RPGs.
Yep.
If it stops being turn-based, people will still end up calling it a JRPG just because it's made in Japan, but that's not accurate anymore, and it's not descriptive either.
I'm still struggling to honestly think of other examples, like pre Dragon Age and The Witcher, I guess, that are examples of non-JRPGs, like Fable.
I mean, you can go back really far and find a lot of stuff. It's really just saying, are you looking for a 3D game that fits into the term RPG, where you have a skills system? One thing that threw me off, I wasn't aware of this, a lot of people don't call Pokemon a JRPG. Like, it clearly is. I've always called it that.
Yeah, like a monster training RPG.
Well, it's since kind of created its own genre at this point. But I remember early back in the Red and Blue days that there were some publications that would refer to it as a RPG. And
yeah,
that was distinct because they weren't calling it a JRPG, they were calling it RPG.
And that makes a lot of sense now for the derogatory nature of the comment, that he's saying, like, it's treated this way, and in publications they might call a game that's fun an RPG, and one that they don't particularly find fun, they call a JRPG. So that straight up racist.
No, that actually makes sense, because, like, I've heard, like, just people describe it in such a way, just like, I don't like JRPGs or whatever, or that game is too, it's too much of a JRPG or something.
Yeah, I've definitely said that like 10, 15 years ago.
Yeah, and like, meanwhile, like I said earlier, I was always just like, no, I love these games. Why would you ever not love these games?
To me, when you're saying it, it sounds more like you're saying you don't like an RPG that's more complex than the norm, just has a lot of mechanics to it.
Exactly.
You have to learn and get used to.
That's not accurate, because EVE Online is an RPG, and it's the most fucking complicated game.
Anytime I think JRPG, you know, I think server-based, though.
But then that's...
And that's an MMORPG.
That becomes the next issue you have with the English language. It evolves, and everybody uses it slightly differently, so these definitions are different for every person you talk to.
That's also a good point for a language barrier, that people in Japan being told JRPG is the term for your game in the United States could have thought of it as being derogatory when it was not meant that way, and it was meant that way. Because depending on the person talking, it could have been, I'm being derogatory or I'm not. This is the most useless fucking tool. It does.
I was wondering if you could pick it up a little bit higher.
I'm going to put it over here. You're going to the corner.
Because you're bad.
And think about what you're not doing.
I would just stack a couple of them together.
I would just go up the first floor of the scaffold. Oh,
nice.
I'm going to get a ladder. You've been utilizing the ladder
this whole time.
I haven't had a reason to. I've been jumping up on top of shit.
Come on, Garrett.
The Scorpion Sentinel in general, like back in the day, was such a cool little boss to start the game off with, too. Like, it just
and also the nature of how this, boss fighting Final Fantasy really worked. You know?
Yeah, yeah, that concept of just like learning the boss fight, learning when and what to do, like what makes it different from another enemy, rather than it just having a lot more health, was like, I don't know.
Literally introduced the weakness system of telling him, hey, you know, use thunder. This is how you like one shot this guy.
And yet somehow some people couldn't even for some reason
be named.
Just couldn't beat him. Like, I don't, that baffles the mind, really.
It's weird. Maybe I was in a weird
now that I think about it, I think mood. Barrett even screams throughout the fight, don't attack when it's tail up. Cloud, look, it's tails up, don't attack.
Yeah, he does.
If you think I read dialogue in video games, you don't know that I only play Rocket League.
I think it stops the fight for a moment. Like, it makes all the other menus go away.
No, I don't believe that for a second. Until I go back and play it, this is all just not true. It's just opinions.
I don't think these are opinions at all. It could be wrong facts. None of these can be opinions.
Whose side are you on, Sean?
I'm the English teacher here, motherfucker.
Yeah, well, I teach maths. And this logic don't make sense right now. Why is everybody attacking me?
I thought I was playing. I don't know anymore, though.
Nobody has their name. Everybody has someone else's name. Damn it.
Where is it even dirty? I don't even see it.
Is this like... Oh,
if you see orange shininess, that's me hitting tab and looking at where the dirt is. And I've seen a few spots, but up here specifically is what I'm cleaning right now.
Oh my god, look at a little smudge, just a little schmutz.
It says head casing, so this thing is specifically what I'm trying to clean.
Oh.
Also, how the hell do you have $11,000?
That carried over from the campaign. In this and the other special ones for Tomb Raider, my money carried over, and so did my power washers. So I actually don't need any money, because I can't buy soap. I'm not allowed to buy soap here.
You can't afford soap. You
can't get soap?
It's sold out.
They're the most powerful Shinra corporation.
If I check here and look at equipment... No, not equipment. It's actually in cleaning liquids. All of it is out of stock. I'm not allowed to buy it.
Shinra bought it all up.
Oh, that's all the material.
I mean, I'm cleaning their shit. That would be stupid for them to buy it and then not give the power washer some of the shit that he needs.
Maybe it's in there.
they got a guy that really...
so little.
Sounds like Heidinger.
Yeah, I was going to say, they got a guy that really likes to just rub it all over himself. Like, it goes to him. You don't need it.
Fun fact.
Woo, fun fact.
Fun fact time.
Sephiroth uses one whole bottle and a half of conditioner on his hair every time he washes his hair.
That is a fact.
That does not sound
now
like
that. Now you know where all his soap goes.
That makes sense.
Is that why it's so damn long and luscious? And
yeah,
he probably used L'Oreal for kids because there's no more tears in that?
Now, Sephiroth does have a long and complicated history with the Shinra Corporation as well. Like, going
clan
back
wrist?
Years and years. Now, depending
where's
on,
the claw wrist?
Like, now, were you scraping the goop off of, like, of young heroes off of those feet? Like, or was that rust? Because this thing hasn't pooped in a while.
It was all... It looked like it was oxidization on
top left,
copper.
Top left.
There it is.
Yeah.
Please lower your arm, you big fuck.
If you ask Shinra, it's the guts of terrorists.
Ah, yes.
Terrorist, freedom fighter, it all depends on who you're asking.
It's got a little terrorism on its feet, that's all.
Bombing my reactors and dropping my plates.
Because again, cannot stress enough, when you encounter the Scorpion Sentinel for the first time, you have just planted a bomb in a power plant. And you are running from said bomb.
And then this jerk stops you and he doesn't give you any hints during the battle as to how to beat him. That's a real hard battle for anybody who hasn't played it.
The Scorpion does not
the
give you
one black hints. Guy in all of Midgar tells you.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, we're done. You guys shut the fuck up. You get to see this wonderful little time lapse of cleaning off the giant fucking sentinel thing.
You never see the scaffolding.
Oh, wow, you don't.
Yeah, they don't show you any of the equipment. That is it for this one. And so everybody can be done with the Sentinel Scorpion thing. I don't know what the next mission is, but we'll talk about it next time. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.
Closing that wiki tab.